Hello and welcome to Module 19 of your Fast Track to Pregnancy program. How long should it take to get pregnant? If you've progressed through all the modules in order so far, you should now feel really confident in being able to accurately identify your fertile days each cycle and know when to have sex to give you your best chance of getting pregnant. So, assuming you are timing sex correctly, how long can you expect it to take to conceive? Firstly, it might be helpful to know that even if you get your timing right, your chance of getting pregnant each month is only between 30 and 40% at absolute best. Another way to look at it is that even if you have sex on your most fertile days, there's still a 60 to 70% chance that you won't get pregnant in a given month. Which sounds incredible, especially when we've spent most of our reproductive life trying to avoid getting pregnant. But actually, human beings are one of the least fertile species on the planet, and it can sometimes take quite some time to get pregnant. So overall, how long can you expect it to take? Recently, there have been a number of really helpful scientific studies that have given us a better picture of the overall time it takes to get pregnant and the proportion of couples that are able to get pregnant naturally. One really excellent study found that for couples using fertility-focused intercourse or having sex during their fertile window each cycle, 81% will get pregnant within just 6 menstrual cycles of trying. And out of the couples who don't get pregnant within the first 6 cycles, about half of those will conceive within the next 6 menstrual cycles, so that 92% of couples will get pregnant within 12 menstrual cycles of correctly timed intercourse. So what this means is for couples who are consistently timing sex for their fertile window each cycle, only about 8% won't be pregnant by the end of 12 menstrual cycles of trying. Now, I know that your brain has probably already jumped to the worst case scenario here and is already thinking, yes, but what if I'm in that 8%? Well, another study found that for couples who don't conceive within the first year of trying, depending on age, between 43 and 63% will conceive within the second year of trying. The study found that even for women in their late 30s, when we know that fertility is lower, more than 90% will still conceive naturally within 2 years. And it's thought that only about 5% of couples are actually truly infertile, that is, unable to conceive without the help of assisted reproduction techniques. So if you haven't been diagnosed with a fertility issue yet, and you've been trying to conceive for less than 2 years, there's still a good chance of getting pregnant naturally. Having said that though, I'm certainly not suggesting that you wait for 2 years to see if you can conceive naturally. Far from it. In fact, my philosophy is that precious time should not be wasted. And if you do have a genuine fertility issue, you deserve to find out as soon as possible so that you can get any investigation and treatment you need without delay. And that's what I'll be focusing on over the next couple of modules. But before we move on to this, I just want to answer a question that you've probably already asked yourself a number of times. And that is, why do some couples take longer than others to get pregnant? You probably know couples that just seem to look at each other and get pregnant, right? While others, and maybe you're one of them, seem to struggle for a really long time. Perhaps for over a year or more, before finally getting pregnant, even though sex has been timed correctly most menstrual cycles. Having reduced fertility, which increases the time it takes to get pregnant, is known as subfertility or being subfertile. If you're subfertile, often it is possible to get pregnant naturally, but it typically takes much longer than average. So why is this? What causes subfertility? Subfertility can be caused by a number of different factors, but sometimes there's no obvious reason for taking longer to conceive, and this can be really frustrating. But here are some of the more common causes of subfertility. Unhealthy eggs or sperm, and this is often due to poor diet or lifestyle factors. Age, either partner being older, generally over 35 for women and the late 30s and beyond for men. Either partner being overweight or underweight. Low sperm count in the male partner or endometriosis in the female partner. Autoimmune conditions like celiac disease, thyroid issues, or rheumatoid arthritis. And hormone imbalance conditions such as polycystic ovary syndrome, or imbalances arising from things like stress, overexercising, or not eating enough. Now, obviously, some causes of subfertility are beyond your control, like being older or having endometriosis. But improving factors that you do have control over, like your diet and lifestyle, can make a real difference and definitely help you conceive sooner rather than later. Committing to a healthy, nutrient-dense diet and a fertility-enhancing lifestyle will go a long way to ensure that you not only get pregnant as soon as possible, but more importantly, that you have a healthy pregnancy and a healthy baby. Sperm take around 10 weeks to develop and mature, and eggs take around 4 months. So the environment you create within your body over that time will affect the ultimate health and vitality of your eggs and sperm and your likelihood of conception. What this means, though, is that unfortunately there's no quick fix or magic pill when it comes to optimizing your fertility health. Any fertility-friendly changes that you put in place today will take at least 3 to 4 months to take full effect. And although that might seem a long time to commit to healthy living, it will definitely be worth the effort in the long run. It's outside the scope of this program to discuss the different ways you can optimize your fertility health, but I've put together a resource called 10 Tips to Boost Your Fertility, which you'll find under the Program Introduction tab. And if you follow the advice that I outline in this resource, you'll definitely be on the road to peak fertility, and in combination with timing sex correctly, maximizing your chances of getting pregnant quickly. But if you'd like one-to-one support and advice on how to improve your fertility naturally, based on your individual health history and circumstances, I'm here to help. I have an online consultation package designed specifically for this purpose, called the Natural Fertility Package. If you'd like to find out more about my online consultations or the Natural Fertility Package, please feel free to contact me or visit my website using the links under the support tab at the end of the program. And that brings us to the end of Module 19. I hope you found this helpful and that you're feeling comforted by the fact that given enough time, most couples do eventually get pregnant naturally. But what if you don't? How do you know if you have a genuine fertility problem? That's what I'll be discussing in Module 20, and I'll show you how to use your fertility charts to identify a potential problem and to fast-track any investigation you might need. I look forward to seeing you there soon. Bye for now.